أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Welcome my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our siyam and may Allah accept our qiyam this great month, the month of Ramadan, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, we fast one day. MashaAllah, takbir. InshaAllah, ya Rabbi Alameen. May Allah accept it from us. Ameen, inshallah. It's good to see Muslims coming to the masajid of Allah Azza wa Jal. It's good to see these faces full of light and nur and the iman. It's good to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, preparing. It's His promise. Lots of ajr, reward for the Muslimin, for the mu'mineen, for those who used to fast and make qiyam and sadaqah, and those who recite the Quran al-Kareem. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, may Allah help us all, ya Rabb, inshallah, to worship Him more and to do good this month. Ameen ya Rabb. As you know, the sunnah or nafila, Allah Azza wa Jal will reward you as if you make farida this month. You know, when you make farida, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you as if you make 70 farida. MashaAllah. Same thing. When you recite the Quran al-Kareem, for each letter you recite, or you listen, or you hear the Quran al-Kareem, 10 hasana, it will be multiplied to 70, MashaAllah, in the month of Ramadan. It's a great reward. We have to know the value of our guest, the month of Ramadan. Our example today, inshallah, as I talk every night, about the examples of the Holy Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Hud, مَثَلُ الْفَرِيقَيْنِ كَالْأَعْمَى وَالْأَصَمْ وَالْبَصِيرِ وَالسَّمِيعِ هَلْ يَسْتَوْيَانِ مَثَلَ أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. I'm using my tafsir, Nur al-Bayan, في تفسير القرآن الكريم, to explain this ayat or these examples. And I put it in very easy way, simple. Everybody can read it, can understand it. I don't need to put a lot of philosophy and a lot of words around the meaning and people get confusion. No, put it simple. You understand the Arabic, put it in the right way in English. In easy way, everybody can get the meaning, that's it. The main thing, you understand the Arabic. Because the Quran, Allah sent it with the Arabic language. You understand deeply the meaning of the ayah, or the ayah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it, ala murad Allah, that's it, you got it. You don't need to put too much spicy. You don't need this spicy too much. Okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I put a title for these examples. Surah Hud, verse number 24. I put the example, the title for this ayah, the likeness of the believers and the disbelievers. This is my title. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَثَلُ الْفَرِقَيْنِ, the believers and the disbelievers. كَالْأَعْمَى وَالْأَصَمْ وَالْبَصِيرُ وَالْسَمِيعُ هَلْ يَسْتَوْيَانِ مَثَلًا أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. The meaning is the likeness of the two parties, two groups, the believers and the disbelievers, is like the blind and the deaf and the seeing and the hearing. Subhanallah. Somebody blind, deaf. He can't see, he can't listen. And another group or party, they are seeing and hearing. They can see and they can hear. This is the likeness of the believers and the disbelievers. Are they, Allah is asking now, هل يستويان مثلا, are they equal in conversion? Of course they are not. And there are too many ayat in the Holy Quran carrying the same meaning. Allah asking and He answered. Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are they equal in conversion? So would you still pay no heed? أفلا تذكرون? Open your mind, listen. Give heed to that. فالله سبحانه وتعالى is giving us this example. Brothers, the distance between the believers and the disbelievers, it's big and wide. Big distance. Big distance. Big distance between the disbelief and the belief. Big distance between somebody walking in a Sirat al-Mustaqim and somebody munharif, somebody rebellious, somebody going astray from Allah, his Lord, his God, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is big different and big distance between somebody obedient to Allah and somebody disobedient. Between the ta'a itself, being obedient, being disobedient, being good or bad, big distance between that. فرق كبير جدا. When we give these examples in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, now you can think and reflect and can understand. Ask yourself, which one of these two groups are you? Which way you are going? You take it, your final way to your final destination in this life to lead you to your Jannah or wal-iyazu billah to the hellfire. We have to know that. Now you're gonna know the reality of yourself and the reality of everybody around you. Insan basir, somebody can see very well, seeing. And somebody blind, a'ma. Somebody deaf, subhanallah. And somebody can see and can hear. You can realize the reality. Somebody is living in the mercy of Allah. Rahmat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does it mean? You live in the way of the mercy of Allah. You live while Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showering you with His mercy and rahmah. Mercy means what? Could be being healthy, wealthy, wisdom, you have wisdom. Could be you have knowledge, money, it's all rahmah. It could be very good wife, pious, mu'mina, she's helping you, mashallah. Could be you have some good kids, حق عبد الجبار. عاشق محمد، عاشق محمد، أغلبها. This is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you live this kind of life. And somebody else, والعياذ بالله, he is 24 under the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. غضب الله عز وجل. Allah is not happy of him because he's going to different direction. He's going to different direction. All the universe, all the creatures of Allah, the creation, subhanallah, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, they are in this way or that way, and that person is in that way alone himself. And in the end, he's crying, why I am like that? Why I'm going to the hellfire? Why my life is upside down? Why I'm not happy? Not because Allah, not because the people too, why you put it in the shoulder of somebody else? Look at yourself, because of you. You are going different direction. حمل السلم بالعرض واتخبط. ده معناها. سبحان الله ماشي. You're going to different direction completely. Look what Allah Almighty سبحانه وتعالى said. والليل إذا يغشى والنهار إذا تجل. Allah swears. He swears by something and the opposite of it. And the opposite. They are not equal. When Allah putting the opposite thing in the same surah and same ayat means He's trying to, Allah is telling you, open, pay heed, pay attention, listen. I'm giving something opposite to something else. Why? To compare. Huh? Compare yourself with somebody else. Are you a good mu'min, a real mu'min or not? Are you in the right way or not? You have to think like this way. And Allah said, He sweared by what? وَاللَّيْلِ, by the night. When the night comes and cover everything. وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا تَجَلَّ, when you see the brightness of the day. وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا تَجَلَّ, when the sun comes, mashallah, shh, noor, light everywhere. The darkness of the night is not equal to the brightness of the day. The mu'min is not equal to non-mu'min. This believer is not equal to the believer. The good mu'min, the good person is not equal to the bad one. We have to think like this way. And Allah is giving you the examples in the Quran to open your mind. وَاللَّيْلِ is word by layl, by the night. And when the darkness of the night comes and cover everything. وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا تَجَلَّ. And he said, وَمَا خَلَقَ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى. The one who created, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who created the male and the female. وَمَا خَلَقَ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى. إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. Look at this meaning. Whatever you're doing, guys, all of you, brothers, sisters, you are completely different from each other's. Somebody is waking up in the morning. Subhanallah, is going, and he starts his day with Salat al-Fajr. With Zikr Allah. Somebody else, he ends his day and his night with haram, and he starts his day with haram. He's in the way of shaitan. إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. Somebody, mashallah, has business, somebody engineer, somebody doctor, somebody, subhanallah, we are different in too many things. In too many things. سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى is different, مختلف. We are different completely. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, because of that, listen to this. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. The one who gave and give for the sake of Allah, he gives sadaqah, charity. For the sake of Allah, a'ta, he give. He likes to give, not to take. Huh? Wattaqa, while he's doing that, he has a fear of Allah in his heart, and he's doing that for just for the sake of Allah. Wasaddaqa bil husna. This ayat talking about Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, radiyallahu anhu arda. The one who gave, the one who had the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his heart. Huh? That's why Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, if the iman of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq will be in one scale, and the iman of the whole entire Muslim ummah in another one, the iman of Abu Bakr will be higher than or heavier than all. Why? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq was very skinny man, short guy. He had hump in his shoulder, no flesh in his face. This Abu Bakr Siddiq, what do you think? Yeah? Muscles. Hogan. This was not Hogan, but he was better than Hogan. Millions of Hogans, you know. Abu Bakr Siddiq, he gave for the sake of Allah. He sacrificed himself, his children, his family. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu arda. He will enter Jannah with Rasulullah and Umar like that. Three of them. Quran talk highly about Abu Bakr Siddiq. Rasulullah talk highly about Abu Bakr Siddiq. He reached the level of Siddiqiyya. Siddiqiyya after the Anbiya. Al-Anbiya was Siddiqeen wal-Anbiya wal-Mursaleen. Said, فَوْلَيْكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ. Number two was Siddiqeen. Abu Bakr Siddiq, Siddiqiyya. وَالشُّهَدَاء وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسَنَ أُولَيْكَ رَفِيقَ. You can be with them in the same level, inshallah. How? وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ. Just to obey Allah and His Messenger. That's it. Ya Rab, I'm not a Nabi. I'm going to be in the level of a Nabi, yes. Just to obey Allah and His Messenger, that's it. I'm not a Siddiq, I'm not a Shaheed. How can I reach that level? So just to obey Allah and the Rasul, that's it. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهُ وَالرَّسُولِ فَأُولَئِكَ those who obeyed Allah and His Messenger will be with النبيين والصدقين والشهداء الصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيق. اللهم اجعلني وإياكم منهم واجمعنا يا رب together in the Firdaus الأعلى. آمين. And Allah said, وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى. What's the الْحُسْنَى? الْحُسْنَى, I can say in Arabic, the best thing, anything good. The best. What is the best? لا إله إلا الله. Somebody say الْحُسْنَى means الْجَنَّى. But no, the right tafsir of this, الْحُسْنَى means لا إله إلا الله. He believed in لا إله إلا الله. Allah is one. And he acts and he practices Islam. Look to another one. وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ, the dark sight, وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى, and those, and that one, which is, he's very stingy, and وَاسْتَغْنَى, وَاسْتَغْنَى, he said, oh Allah, I am a self-sufficient, I don't need you. This is the meaning of وَاسْتَغْنَى, يقول لك يا اخي انت استغنيت، انت عدت غني يا اخي، خلاص ها خلاص you don't need us anymore، استغنيت يا عم، هذا معناه استغنى، استغنى خلاص. He came to the level he said I don't need Allah، والعياذ بالله استغنى. عند الله سيد ذات سورة اقرأ فرس سورة عند القرآن وديد الله سيد اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق الإنسان، اقرأ ربك الذي علم الإنسان، كلا إن الإنسان لا يطغى أن رآه استغنى. The man transgress when he see himself استغنى. استغنى means he came to the level he said I am the best, I am the richest, I am the superpower. خلاص nobody like me. فthat kind of person is stingy and he said I don't need Allah, I am استغنى, I am self-sufficient now, I don't need God. While he's doing that وكذب بالحسنى. What's الحسنى؟ لا إله إلا الله. He denied لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله means there is no God but Allah. He denied the oneness of God. Allah is one. He said no. Allah is two. Allah is three. Allah is whatever. No. He described, he gave different description to God, to Allah. No. Allah is one above his seven heavens, above his throne. He's so high. He's not equal to us. He's not similar to us. بلا تكييف ولا تمثيل ولا تعطيل ولا تشبيه. Nothing equal to Allah. ليس كمثله شيء هو السميع البصير سبحانه وتعالى. That's why he said ولم يكن له كفواً عن كفواً أحد. Nothing equal to Allah. That person stingy. He think he's self-sufficient. He denied لا إله إلا الله the oneness of God. Allah said فسنيسره للعسرة will make his task, his affairs very difficult for him in this life. Not just in this life, and hereafter too. Brothers, today my example about the disbelievers and the believers. And too many ayat talk about that. As I said, when we talk with each other here in this life, when we talk about this brother, that brother, these sisters, subhanAllah, who are from different countries, who are in the United States, different countries, different colors, different tongue, different language. And subhanAllah, we are different in color, different in power, different in too many things. But all of us, all of this human being, in the sight of Allah Azza wa Jal, we are two types, either good or bad, obedient, disobedient, believer, disbeliever. That's it. We are in the sight of Allah like this. You have to count yourself. Somebody doing good, somebody doing bad, somebody muqbil, somebody is coming to Allah, somebody is running away from Allah. Huh? And Allah said in Surah Al-Sajdah, أَفَمَنْ كَانَ مُؤْمِنًا كَمَنْ كَانَ فَاسِقًا. Allah answered, لَا يَسْتَوُونَ. The meaning is, can one who is a believer become like one who is a sinner? They cannot be equal. They cannot be equal in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at this ayah in Surah Al-Jathiyah. Allah said, أَمْ حَسِبَ الَّذِينَ اجْتَرَحُوا السَّيِّئَاتِ أَنْ نَجْعَلَهُمْ كَالَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ سَوَاءً مَحْيَاهُمْ وَمَمَاتُهُمْ سَاءَ مَا يَحْكُمُونَ. Those who used to do sin, the sinners, they think Allah will deal with them in this worldly life and the hereafter equally to those who used to make good deeds while they believe in the oneness of Allah during their life, سَوَاءً مَحْيَاهُمْ, during their lifetime here and وَمَمَاتُهُمْ in the hereafter or since they die, سَاءَ مَا يَحْكُمُونَ. You're not fair. They are not equal. They are not equal. The criminals must be in jail and the good people must be free. The criminals must be punished in our life, in our law. In the court of Allah, same thing. Same thing. Do good, you will find the good waiting for you there. Do bad, you're going to find the bad thing waiting for you there. In the court of Allah, what about in our court, this is happening. Go kida, harm anybody, look what's going to happen to you. The police is going to come and take, and go to jail. Wait until the judge is going to decide for your, what you're going to happen, to happen to you, what's going to happen to you. This is our life. The believer, brothers, sisters, he knows, al-mu'min, he knows why Allah Azza wa Jal did create him. Do you know why Allah created you? Do you know why? The believer knows that. He knows his job. Some of us until now, I cannot claim you don't know, you know everything. But nazari, just oral. But when you come to the practice, no, we are away, wallahi. You have to know your job. Your job is to worship Allah. Ya Shaykh, al-amal is ibadah. I'm not saying al-amal is not ibadah. But come to, don't deceive yourself. Don't deceive yourself. You have to work, you have to do everything. But the main thing in your life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even when you feed your kids, when you work and you do all of your good deeds, to please Allah. I'm feeding my kids for the sake of Allah. I am raising my kids in a good way, in Islam, for the sake of Allah. I am doing my good deeds for the sake of Allah. All of this. Brothers, the real mu'min, the one who know the reality of this life. الدنيا دار التواء وليس دار استواء. الدنيا دار التواء وليس دار استواء. الدنيا دار طرح وليس دار فرح. We're not in Jannah yet. For that's why you have to understand that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he gave us the taklif of the sharia, of the deen, he gave us the taklif fitting our capability or our ability. He said, I will give you desire. I will put desire in your brain, in your mind, in your body. But that desire, for example, he said, you can go and marry and you can make intercourse. You can do the same intercourse, but you do it in a haram way. You're going to be punished. But marry, I'm going to give you certain tracks. You can go through these tracks and do it. The same thing can be haram. You can do it in a halal way. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to your capability, He's giving you the tashri' of Islam. Brothers, nothing hidden in our deen and our Islam. Alhamdulillah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before he died, he showed us everything, nothing hidden. And he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tarakana ala al-mahajat al-bayda, layluha wadih kanahariha. Everything being shown to us, clear to us. And you have to trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will finish this example tonight with this. You have to trust Allah and trust His promise. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Qasas, the narratives, chapter, verse number 61.
أَفَمَنْ وَعَدْنَاهُ وَعْدًا حَسَنًا فَهُوَ لَاقِيهِ كَمَنْ مَتَّعْنَاهُ مَتَاعَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا ثُمَّ هُوَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنَ الْمُحْضَرِينَ
Look to this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in this example. Trust Allah. Trust His promise. Can the person with whom we had a fair promise, which is good for him, we have a fair promise which is good for him, be compared to the one to whom we provided a good, easy, earthly life, then on the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring him before him. He will be brought to Allah, before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The meaning of this ayah, two brothers, one of them, he is very poor, يعني عالجنت. Has nothing with him. Mayyit. No life. No even $1 in his bucket. Very poor person. And that person, he has a brother. Only brother for him. His brother was very rich. There is no limit for his wealth. And that rich man, suddenly, just two brothers in this life. Suddenly, he died. Who will inherit him? I'm asking you. His brother, right? Yes, his brothers. Who? The poor man. He's going to inherit him. But they said, no, wait. They give a condition to that poor man. Listen, you have until we transfer the paperwork and the wealth and everything that's need, just almost 2 years. Make it 1 year. 1 year. Until we get you all the money and the wealth of your brother to your account, you need 1 year. Tell me about the condition of that Hajjaj Jabbar. Are that person going to be happy or not? Is he going to be happy or not? The poor person. No? He's very poor. And 1 year he will be, he get a promise with there is no limit for the wealth, money. And he's poor, he's nothing. He going to be happy or not? Of course. But he's still 1 year also. There is no nothing in his hand. He's going to be happy, right? Do you agree with me, all of you? Huh? لا, why?
Anything could happen with him.
He's poor anyway.
He's poor anyway, but he get a promise with no limit, money, wealth.
But he didn't get the money. Better than nothing.
Yeah, doctor?
Better than nothing. He would be happy. He'd be happy 3 years.
Wallahi, without thinking, he will be so happy, jamaat al-khair. I will tell you something. Don't make it difficult for yourself. You, all of you, somebody gonna tell us tonight in the Islamic Center of Rasida, every one of you are gonna get $5 million after 1 year. What do you think? You're gonna be happy or not?
Yeah.
You're gonna dance right now. I'm gonna come Rasida every day. Of course. This is okay. This is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us. Life is very short. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us with what? Jannah. Even if you have no money, you have no wealth, you have nothing now. But the promise of Allah, I think, وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَدِيثًا. Brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us a good promise. وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. الْآخِرَةُ will last and bitter. This dunya is a mirage, is nothing. We are passing by. If Allah gave you a promise with Jannah, do this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What? Just 5, wallah, I mean it. A man came to Rasulullah, said, Ya Rasulullah, what did Allah ask me to do? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking you to say la ilaha illallah, salah, zakah, hajj if you can, and make zakah if you can too. And he said, wallahi, I will not increase anything. And he left. There is nothing extra. And Rasulullah said two hadith, sadaqa in falah. Aflaha in sadaq. That man will be successful if he will be honest. And another hadith said, dakhala al-jannah in sadaq. If he will do that, just the farida, he will enter Jannah. It's a promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us to many ayat also here in the Quran. أَفَمَنْ وَعَدْنَاهُ وَعْدًا حَسَنًا فَهُوَ لَقِيهِ كَمَنْ مَتَّعْنَاهُ مَتَاعَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. The promise of Allah for you, Jannah there. But if somebody enjoy his life with useless stuff, nothing in this dunya, dirt above dirt, no, I'm waiting for the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers, again, there is a big distance between the believers and the disbelievers, the mu'min and the non-mu'min, and the good and the bad person, being obedient and being disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, I will finish with this, Surah Al-Qalam, verse number 36. أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَالْمُجْرِمِينَ. Do you think Allah will deal equally between the criminals and the Muslims? No way. They will never be in the same place or scale or same level in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَا لَكُمْ كَيْفَ تَحْكُمُونَ. You have to be fair when you judge. Somebody used to pray fajr, somebody used to come for tarawih, somebody used to make sadaqah, iftar, zakah, he used to read the Quran, somebody doing all of these good deeds all of his life. He gonna be equal to somebody sayah outside? Somebody he doesn't know what he's doing, why he's not living? No way, no way. Two students, both of them, somebody study all the year and he approached, he reached his level of studying and somebody's playing. Do you think they're gonna pass the test? They are not equal. No, they are not equal. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers, Allah will protect the mu'min. Allah will protect the mu'min, will sustain him in his life from his enemy. Al-mu'min, he is mutawazin. He is the person of, I can say, of moderation. Moderation. When he walk, when he talk, when he eat, when he laugh, when he love, when he hate. Moderation, tawazin, balance everything. Don't love too much. Don't hate too much. أحبب حبيبك هونا ما عسى أن يكون بغيضك يوما ما وأبغض بغيضك يوما هونا ما عسى أن يكون حبيبك يوما ما. Don't love too much. Don't hate too much. Don't eat too much during Ramadan. Don't laugh too much. Don't be sad too much. Balance everything. وكذلك جعلناكم أمة وسطا. We are the أمة وسط in everything. Why we see Daesh everywhere now? The killers everywhere now. And these people, those who are killing Muslims before non-Muslims. Because there is no balance in their life. There is no balance in their life. There is no وسطية. لا إفراط ولا تفريط. This is what the scholars of the Aqidah they said. You cannot make stretch your hand like this and you can make it like that. This is what the Quran said. ولا تجعل يدك مغلولة إلى عنقك ولا تبسطها. Even when you spend moderation, everything moderation. Moderation, brothers, very important, inshallah. رب العالمين. Turn your face to Allah. وأقيموا وجوهكم عند كل مسجد. When you see the masjid, turn your face to the masjid. Don't turn your back to the masjid. وأقيموا وجوهكم عند كل مسجد. أسعد الناس. The happiest person in this life. The one who has that feeling. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with me. I am with Allah. Allah loves me. When you come to that point, you're going to be the happiest. Nobody can harm you. Wallah ya jama'a, if somebody, inshallah, Qasim Bhai, you're going to finish. Qasim Bhai will leave, bye bye. Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. You know, that Saidi, was bigger than me, was drowning. وبعدين بقول الحقوني, help me, help. And somebody is telling me, alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. The man saying, help, as alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. Ya am, help me, I'm going to die. Qasim Bhai, bully, bye bye. جزاكم الله خير إن شاء الله. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى accept from all of you. We love you all for the sake of Allah. I would like إن شاء الله to this number to be extra double tomorrow إن شاء الله رب العالمين. To the end of Ramadan, please. يا جماعة, if you stand behind the Imam, صلاة التراويح, Allah will forgive your sin. Don't come just for a couple of days and that's it. No. We need to have good resolution from tonight إن شاء الله. إن شاء الله to the end of Ramadan we're gonna stand. We'll not leave the Imam. We're gonna fast. And this is the time of racing, race with each others, compete with each others. وفي ذلك فليتنافس المتنافسون. جزاكم الله خيرا.